Hi guys, I'm Adam Wilborn from WOG. Whoa, what's all this about? I know I'm not Simon Miller, but come on, at least give me a chance.
Sorry, I can't.
Yes, they all turn on you eventually. As Ric Flair famously once put it, you want to see someone doing well, but not doing better than you. The fans turned on Hulk Hogan as his short-term magic failed to ignite long-term interest in the camp-as-balls WCW version of his character. Of course, Hulk Hogan didn't let it affect him, probably because he lives in a fantasy world of his own creation, but still.
Sounds like they're saying Boo Earns, brother.
They turned on John Cena and Stone Cold Steve Austin, sort of, but both of them aren't asked about what you think either. Instead, this list is focused on those, a bit like my relationship with my dad, who do care if you love them or not. I'm Adam Wilborn from What Culture, and these are five WWE babyfaces who couldn't handle getting booed. Number five, Ronda Rousey. We're fickle bastards sometimes, aren't we? Honestly, in one comment section, you're a soy boy SJW libtard cuck just for using the word pretext. I know that feeling. And in another arena, you get absolutely crapped on for going the other route, ripping into people who wear skinny jeans and munch on avocados. I think you'll find they contain more potassium than bananas, Ronda. Such was the fate that Ronda Rousey suffered at Survivor Series. After taking fans on a wild ride and taking a series of very stiff kendo shots, Ronda sold the injury, perhaps hoping for a standing ovation or even just a bit of gratitude. Nope. Instead, the fans booed her right out the building. Ronda either healed herself with her anti-millennial patter or won too much and thus became Super Ronda. Just like to point out those are the same fans who moan about 50-50 booking. Yeah, welcome to what it's really like in WWE, Ronda. Get used to it. Number four, Batista. Batista or Bootista or Blueista, whatever he was known as at the time, he became WWE's top heel immediately following his not-so-triumphant return. He wasn't merely not Brian, he was essentially the opposite of the man that fans were defiant in their support of. Where Brian accelerated through the lengthy incandescent matches that made him a megastar, Batista was gassed despite entering late into the 2014 Royal Rumble. And most obviously of all, where Brian wasn't in the Royal Rumble, Batista was. Seriously, Vince, mate, what were you thinking? They booed Rey Mysterio. Do you know how much you have to screw up for that to happen? In a candid interview with WWE.com, Batista remarked that it was weird, almost like a personal attack. In truth, it was and it wasn't. It wouldn't have mattered if the Batista of old had returned. Fans were already prepared to reject him, especially since the mooted WrestleMania 30 main event against Randy Orton was about as uninspired as a bloody distraction finish. The dready gritted reboot to I hate you, Batista, I hate you too. Big Dave later leaned into the heel role wonderfully, but he telegraphed it earlier by showcasing his contempt to what he perceived as an ungrateful fandom by chucking up the old double digits. Number three, Roman Reigns. On screen, Roman Reigns is a consummate professional with perpetually wet hair. He knows that even if a majority of fans jeer him, or at least used to, young kids still buy his t-shirts. I mean, who wouldn't want one with designs like this? Young kids simply expect their superhero to overcome the obstacles piled against him. He's the big dog.
The big dog!
The big dog!
He has never once let them down by pitching a fit, even in the face of such vicious, relentless heat. But let's be honest here, we were all guilty of conflating the man and the performer. There is a human being behind this divisive sports entertainer, and away from the professional environment, he showed fragility when responding to a relentless stream of Twitter trolls. Stop tweeting at work and earn some money, he responded to one such troll. People at the time cited this as evidence of Roman Reigns' real-life heel credentials, when in reality, it took tragic circumstances to showcase the fact that this was simply a man reacting to the fact that fans could not separate Roman Reigns from Joe. Look, joining in the fun of wrestling's absurd theatre is one thing, especially when WWE actively encourages us to react to Roman Reigns as we see fit. But spouting unnecessary direct hatred on Twitter, at the end of the day, is the real heel move. Number two, Goldberg. Yeah, Goldberg couldn't handle much of anything in WWE first time round. He must have known what he was signing up for, a arduous schedule and a recalibrated character. But WWE didn't know, or simply didn't want to know, who they were signing. The Goldberg of old, a no-selling propulsive force of destruction, was of less interest to Vince McMahon than tag teams are now. In WWE, babyfaces get over by doing the exact opposite of what made him a literal smash success. They sell and sell and sell and sell and sell and sell and sell, and then they make a comeback. Goldberg wasn't great at selling. He clearly didn't want to do it and didn't look comfortable doing it either. Authenticity was speared and jackhammered. Visibly miserable, Goldberg decided to not renew with the company through 2004 and wrestled his last match for 12 years at WrestleMania 20. The hardcore MSG fans knew of this, and Brock Lesnar buggering off too, of course, and so hijacked the match. The babyface and heel reacted by responding to that atmosphere as if they'd rather be anywhere else. Probably because that was true. To underscore how pissed off he was with all this, Goldberg knew he was going over, and yet still put his job face on. Nowadays, though, this is some good shit. Number one, The Rock. Now, normally, The Rock loves to boil piss. The toxic reaction leveled at him in 1997 drastically altered the trajectory of his legendary career. He loved the heat. Just rewatch the original Rock concert in 2003, the utter immolation of the city of Toronto. He basked in the blaze. But it was in Toronto the year prior that we saw the first glimpse of the human being underneath the megastar facade. As Hollywood Hogan literally flexed, reverting to Hulk Hogan in an iconic instant, The Rock's eye involuntarily twitched. Just as quickly though, Rock assumed a pseudo heel role and crafted an improvised masterpiece for the ages. It was a lot more obvious in 2015 though, where removed from WWE, he didn't have a bloody clue what was going on. He turned up to endorse Roman Reigns. All good so far, they're related in case WWE haven't mentioned that enough. Please cheer this man. But The Rock became heel by association. After the initial pop subsided, the insult to the intelligence became clear, and the Philly fans let The Rock have it. The Rock, generally unflappable, flapped. He raised an eyebrow, but this time he wasn't posing. He was questioning with a look of sheer bewilderment what the hell was up with his people. And that's our list. Did we miss any out? Let us know in the comment section below, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And subscribe to What Culture Wrestling on either iTunes, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts from for daily wrestling podcasting. Check out some more of our recent videos here. Thanks for watching. I've been Adam from What Culture, and I'll see you soon.
Do a video channel instead.
Yeah.
Yeah, right, cool.
List, everyone.
List.
Yes.
Woo!